basketball experiences. Program which FIBA Europe is developing really interesting one. And being always between club activity and national team activity is pretty tough for me to, you know, to be able to sometime to do something for this program, but I would be happy if something of what we are gonna talk this morning would be helpful for your activity, for your coach reflection discussion. The point is, the issue of our first lecture is a very basic one. Is decision making. How you can improve your player decision making, which is possibly the most important thing a coach or a player have in basketball, making the right decision at the right time, according to the situation he finds into the court in that specific moment. Offensively speaking, I believe that, I think you would agree with me, that offense is trying to get an advantage doing a certain thing on the court on a certain moment. Whether he's made there, we can play a bigger role in a certain position, we can use a screen. But how many times that first move will bring you that big advantage which will allow you to make a high percentage shot in it? My experience is that very, very seldom it happens. There are two important factors which are conditioning what the offense is trying to do. First of all, it is the talent, the skills of the players. Or you can do the right thing, you can foresee that doing that stuff you will get an advantage, you will have a possibility to take a good shot, but then skills of your players are not enough to execute at the right speed, and you cannot make what you would like. Second point is the defense. Nowadays, the level of the defense in any competition, any level, is so high that it's really difficult that one offensive team send his attack in a certain spot of the court and will immediately get an open shot. Defense is there, defense is preventing that, defense is trying to even with scout, but also with the physical reaction and the preparation of the defense nowadays, and with the athletic skills of the players. Possibly that first try will just create half of advantage. And that's the point. To convert that half advantage, which don't give you the possibility to take a good open shot immediately, to a clear full advantage, which does allow you to, your player of course, to take a good shot. That's the point. Who receives the ball after somebody else tried to get the advantage and somehow attracted more defense on him and made a pass, made the right pass in the right time? Who receives that pass? Possibly right now in today's basketball, is the person, the player who had more, the higher responsibility. Many times, of course, who's going to attack first have the responsibility to create that first attack. But who gets the back? Who gets the second responsibility of attacking the defense is the man. What is going to do? Of course, the responsibility is not stop the ball. That's the main point. Ball must attack aggressively the best. How? With a quick pass, with a shot, with a penetration, a ball doesn't have to stop. That's the key. If ball stops, that half advantage will disappear. And you have to start over. With less seconds on the shot clock, in a static situation, which will make you, get under pressure, clock pressure, and different pressure, because as you know, as you because your experience, tell you, the more shot clock goes ahead, the more the defense feels aggressive and that he's getting into his foot. So, get an advantage or get out of an advantage and make it a full advantage. That's the point. To do it, again, we can, or we should, keep these two big factors clear in our mind. The talent of the player, the skills, the technical ability. Of course, a good shot is not the same for me or for you. A good shot is not the same for a player who's playing in the NBA or a player playing in a good European level or in a junior level. What do I mean? I mean that as a coaches, our flexibility will tell us if that shot is a good shot for that player in that moment, or it's not a good shot and we have to look for, keep attacking to look for something different, something better than that. What I feel, for example, in the NBA is that that's the perfect school, the best school to take tough shots, to teach players to take difficult shots. I mean, there they develop the game, their game, develop a great ability to take very complicated shots one-on-one against the best defensive player in the world, not against the best organized defense in the world, because they are also don't allow them to play too organized like we can do in Europe. But those players, the best one-on-one player in the NBA, are able to take shots. And maybe they are good shots for them to take shots, which our player will never be able to take, most of them. So, the skills, the ability of the player, the talent of the player is one very important factor. We have to teach our player to recognize which are good shots for that specific player and which are not good shots. So, this is a good shot for you. We allow you to take it. This is not a good shot for you. Don't take it. If, of course, we teach them to improve their ability to add new options on their one-on-one, but still it's very important in, the, in our mental training that we teach players to take shots because we consider it a good shot because your ability put you in a situation where you can finish, we can make it, you can make a basket with, let's say, decent percentage, or not to be shot. They're also in the same team, this is a matter of keeping balance into thinking chemistry, balance into your team. A good shot for a player is not a good shot for another player. And sometimes players tell me, why you allow me to take this shot and don't allow me to take this shot? Because right now, we feel as a team that you can take the shot and that you cannot take the shot. You have to be very, very, you know, straightforward and even strict with this. Because otherwise, everybody will feel himself authorized, allowed to take every shot. And it's not the same, for example, heavy. I'm thinking about, for example, Spanish national team player, which is possible, you know much better. Not the same to give opportunity to our Gasol to take a certain kind of shot with two people in, on him. Then give the same possibility to Fran Basket. It's not the same. And Fran must understand that what is allowed to Pau is not allowed to him. Because Pau proved that he can take that more difficult shot. And you can do other things, useful things for him. So first one, first parameter is the talent. The second one is the defense. I mean, the really important thing in this, consider what the defense is giving. Read what, or even sometimes foresee which reaction defense will bring to your trap, to your initiative. One initiative will bring, if it's a good initiative of course, will bring a reaction. We said, very, very seldom the first initiative will give you later, will give you an easy open shot. Defense is there. Defense will get. Read and react to what the defense does. It's absolutely the key. How many mistakes our players do because they decided in advance what they wanted to do. I wanted to penetrate there and kick it there. You can decide to penetrate, not to kick it there, because the difference don't give you the best. You should do different things. Also, with professional teams, many times during the season, I have to rigor the team and say, hey, we are talking about extra, for example, we are talking about extra passes, which is fine, but we are forgetting that if you don't attack the basket aggressively, if you don't go to the rim when you try and when you make your penetration, when you make your bigger or when you make your one-on-one, there will not be extra passes. There will not be helps. You will not force defense to react to your initiative. If you don't force defense to put 1 second man on you, you're not going to create nothing for your team. No open shot for your team. So go back, attacking the basket, strong one-on-one, and focus on how you attack the basket. How strong is your initiative? And then read what is right, what is you know, the defense reaction that will you know, throw to your initiative. That's absolutely important. Many times with high-level players, I had to talk about the fact that their skills, of course, is a parameter. But what the difference, let's say the game, give to the offense, that specific situation, is a much more important parameter. So if you are a good penetrator and there is no space to penetrate, also if you are a good penetrator, you cannot make a penetration. If you are a good shooter, but you are completely defended, and the answer is make a pass or make a penetration, you should make a single pass. Maybe not too difficult penetration, but the answer is pass or penetration. So again, don't decide in advance, beforehand, what you're going to do. Decide how you are going to attack the best. But then, be ready to react to the different reaction. And this is something, getting to our point, which we can teach. Because, of course, defensive reactions are not 300. I mean, when somebody penetrates one way, or somebody can play pick and roll or low post in the spot of the court, defense can do 2, 3, generally speaking, things. Okay, then there are many small details. But teaching our offensive players to react to the most typical defensive reaction, it is putting them in a situation where when they will face in the game those 2, 3 typical reactions, defensive reactions, they will be able to answer. They will be able to remember, because they practice it, they work on that. If the defense does this, I will do that. If the defense do that, I will do this. And this is very, very easily, very simple way, the key of offensive basketball nowadays. Foresee sometimes, read every time what the game gives you, respect the game, take the right decision according to what the game is giving, and of course, according to your skills, execute the right fundamental to answer that defensive reaction. Talking about how we are going to show our experience now, I want to tell you one thing. I believe in show what they did. Of course, we are talking about in 1 hour showing how we try to improve decision making of our players, and this is a job which requires minimum 1 month with the national team, 1 year with club teams. But we are trying to put everything together and try to make a kind of a synthesis of what we try to do with the player. But what we are going to show, it is what we did in everything, either club team, national team. Of course, we cannot do everything what we do in a club team during 1 year, in 1 month with a national team. But to work on fundamental, which player will use in the game, and to work also with senior players, with top level players, with NBA players, in competition time, of course, maybe not the same morning of the game, but sometimes also that. Sometimes I like to shoot around, not to just shoot, but to make them practice the situation they will possibly find in the next night in the game. So we are going to face this kind of pick and roll defense. Let's work on the fundamental we will need to make a good execution. We are going to attack this thing a lot with pin down, zipper screen. Work 5-10 minutes on this. Like a piano player. They practice the top. They practice. So why our player don't have to practice this small thing? Of course, you have to adjust the fundamental to the level of the player. We are not working on fundamental same way with the 14 years old kids or with the national team player. But still, we have to give time to them because this is the base of the game. In the right way according to the level of the player. Yeah. I don't use complicated tricks. I don't like that players must think to the rotation, to the execution of the trick too much. I like the players have to focus on the substance of what they are doing. What we are trying to do basketball-wise with this should absorb 90% of their fault. I don't want them to think when they are making the drill, I have to go there, and then what after? I mean, easy drills, game drills, and especially practice situation which they will find in the game. Of course, there is a progression which is not the same as said before, in any category and level of age. For example, my opinion with the kids, with the 10, 12, 14 years old kid, I would advise to work, also watching, for example, my kid working out in his kids, 50% one way, 50% another way. 50% using best hand, 50% using worst hand, for example. Why? Because they have to get confidence in what they do. And it is good that they practice also a good amount of time with the things which they are better to do. You know, for example, writing with the right or doing, something to make them solid in execution of what their what we believe is important. After, from 14 to 18, 20, I believe that using worst hand more, 60-40, 35-65% of the time, the worst hand is, that's the moment I mean to change percentages, to use and to work more with the worst hand. That range, it's time to challenge them to work, trying to add something new to their game. With professional players, you have to be realistic. I mean, if a player get to, 20, 90 years old player, you're working with your first team, senior team, and there is no way he will start to make that shot or they move with his worst hand. There's no point to waste time practicing that. No point. It's a waste of time. It's stupid. So at that point, it's better we commit together. I mean, it's stupid. Basketball is stupid also mental-wise. I mean, if I think a player should trust what he does, and if he coach proposes to do something which he will not use because he doesn't, at that point of his career, of his life, of basketball life, doesn't feel comfortable to do it. It's really it's something which has even hurt the basketball relationship. So at that point, let's work on player will really use in a game. So if it's at that point, he's not going to use for that move his left hand, forget it. Commit this deep time to make it, to get to a point where he can use consistently his right. But, as a, let's say, first team coach, meaning senior coach, one of the things which I evaluate more from coaches who are working with the young players and which bring the young players to the first team, one of the things which I give more importance to, it is teach players to use two pivot feet maybe, and two hands. This is extremely, extremely important. So if I can give an advice to coach who are working with the children, 14, 15, 16, 17 people, please make them be able to go one way or another way. Don't make them predictable. Don't bring to the first team players who will never be their opponent on their best side, will never use their not more comfortable pivot foot. This is extremely important when you work then offensively, and you can see the importance of this when defensively you prepare a game against the opponent. I mean, it's such easy to give indication. Other issue is they follow your indication, if they have concentration to keep your those indications in the game and do, you know, use them. But it's so easy to prepare a game against the player, and there are a lot, also top level, a lot of players who are really absolutely not effective when they go on their best side, or they are not using good efficiency there, I would say, for the right left pivot foot, not the right pivot foot or the right hand. It's so easy to scout and to prepare a game against this, that turning the medal. Please, give your children, give your kids instructions, work, commit time practice to make them work with both sides. Now, let's go start with kids. I need the nine forwards, okay? So we want to try to work on, or to show the tricks we use to improve decision making of perimeter players. Okay, we will use some big men also, but it will be more to help small to do their job. Okay, so we have nine players. Can we be pretty fast coming in, please? Nine players, three group of three, and three balls. Three balls, please. Three, six, nine. Perfect. Okay, let's go. Very easy. Starting drill. Let's go with the. Give me a group of three. Group of three. One, two, and three. Perfect. Go to the logos, please. Stay right in front of him. Maybe you travel. Same on that side, and same on that side. Okay? So very easy starting, which of course we use. Ready? Ball on the outside the 3-point line right there. That's done. Because you are a good defensive player, you want to give him the responsibility to start offense. Okay, so the issue here is just to make a good pass where he wants to receive. I mean, show him the time. Show him where you want to receive. Here. You will give him trouble to do it. Use the pen. We are not talking about now fundamental. We are talking about put the fundamental into already kind of a team concept. Now we have to make a pen. The big pen to the low ball, but it can be any of the passes we use in the game. So you give him trouble to make his pass. Make it where you want it. Right there. Maybe taking a shorter time with this, okay? When he show the target, he got to receive the ball, okay? When he receive, go do the same job with your team in here, with your short target, stay in here, short target, where do you want to receive the ball? Right there, okay? Keep going, pause, show the ball, show the target, okay? So, we ready? we, offensively speaking, we're the one flesh. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Come on, run and put pressure on the best. You can use a fade, you can use a drip. You can use a fade, you can use a drip. Go, go, fast, fast. Put the position, Michelle. Okay, stop, stop, stop. Stop. Let's rotate. Let's rotate, okay? Go there, go there, go there. Go. Why? We want to be to make the press both hands. Ready? Ready? Let's go. Go. One thing. Stop. Stop. What we want, we start to make them work, and then we start to give them indication. What we do not want, we do not want passes within the body structure, okay? Outside the body, which is right here, right here, right here. Not two hands from the chest, for example, okay? So one hand, two hands, lateral passes, okay? Not over the head, right now, okay? Not two hands from the chest. Go, go, you go, you go. Hey, hey, no, you are not a policeman. You just try to have the flesh, try to have the flesh. Try, okay, flesh, go, go. Come on. Show what you want. Okay. Stop, stop. See that? Immediately, everybody start to see that the bounce pass will more or less reach the goal. Now you can put the more difficult and say, no bounce passes. First. Second, you can put the more competitive, which is something I forgot to say before, something which I like to this kind of drills, put competitive, so, of course, to make Gasol, Gasol and Frank Basket made this drill, you gotta give them something. Maybe with a 14 years old kid, not the problem, go there and do this, okay? What's the competition? How many passes are fulfilled without flexion? How many flashes? So go to 7, for example. Okay? Every player is making 1 point every time he completes the pass without a deflection, and make 1 point every time he is able to deflect it when it's his turn to play defense. Okay? Okay? So now, how many passes are allowed? What more pressure, because you can get the point, and he's doing, let's compete to 3 points. 3 points, okay? Ready? Ready? Let's go. Okay, come on, 1 point, let's go. Okay, 2 points, go. Okay, okay, keep counting your own point. Three, stop. One, 3 points, go, go. Okay? Then again, you can put more difficult group. The offensive execution, saying to the defense, stay on his best shoulder. I mean, stay. Your defensive position will be not straight, but on his right shoulder if he's right. I mean, force him to use his left. Okay? So we can make different variations. Come on, everybody come in. Still two group of three. So first group of three is this, stay under the basket, in the corner, and in the corner. Ball, the ball is coming here, okay? Now, next step would be do the same, but, well, in a more dynamic way. Meaning, make this pass, well, look, go here, go there, go away. Wait, start with the dribble, because I think that when you don't practice dribble, when you do it for the first time, can be. Start with the dribble, go, do the same jump which you were doing before, make composition on the shot, run, make a pass right there, but everything run, okay? Make one dribble, run to make composition on the shot, look at this pass, nah, we don't want to put it all over the head, we want to pass on the trip, okay? So you pass there, run, make composition, okay? Okay, we do it in a dynamic way, kind of a weak. Where we want, we put on position, we contest the pass. Okay? We got it? We got the message? Okay, stay a little bit more inside the court there, there is side, one dribble, go, jump on it, jump, go, come on, go, right here. Start, come on, I will do the jump. All the dribble, in a run, don't stop, go best, run, go dribble, one dribble, right here, okay, move it and run, got it? The ball over your back. Stop! Come on, run! Come on, one dribble. Let's go, one dribble. Go jump on it. Okay, let's do this. Next one. We'll do it better. Come on. Stop. Make your best and jump on your teammate because you are from offensive player becoming defensive player. So be quick. This is something which improve also also the transition of it, be reactive, okay, immediately, not have a pause, have a second, make a pass, see what happens. No, keep playing. You make a pass, you gotta do something different, which is make opposite contact and next pass. Go, ready? Come on, jump on it, go! Come on, keep running, jump on it! Okay, let's move, wait. Ball, stop. Ball is started from one corner. With one grip. Ready? Come on, jump on it. Okay. So we pretend, of course, not to make two hands on the chest. Now we're going to make corrections to the guy who are trying to do the best his first time to execute the ball. Okay? And the pass be received where we want the receiver head, here or there, or where we call the ball. Okay? And the catch, put it in the middle without trembling. On the side, we make this dribble, make a pass on the side, so we can make it work on many fundamentals here, but get to a point where kids are running up and down the floor two times, four times, always controlling the ball, making the right pass, and giving the competitive situation, giving the game 1 point, every pass is completed, 1 point every deflection, to make them, you know, be stay more alive. Okay, now let's do it this way. Okay, good. 1 point every pass completed. 1 point every deflection. Let's go. Come on. Okay. That's it. Come on. Okay. We can also go finish with a layup with a defensive attempt to rush, which is not exactly something which we were trained in the past, but it's good too. So, come on. Okay. We cannot have fumble. We gotta catch the ball and go. Or better be strong right here in his chest. The catch is creeping outside and be a fast move. Because if we do it slowly, we can have traveling violation. Okay? So, come on. Well, okay, more or less. Okay, go, that's it. We got it? So, now, still three groups of three. Let's go with the man with the ball here. Man without the ball right there. In front of the elbow. And one man with the ball. Right here. Same the other two groups. Okay? Man with the ball behind. Man without the ball there. Man without the ball right there. Okay? Now, our three coaches participate, actually they sweat though, because I want, especially at the beginning, or even, not necessarily only at the beginning, that they do the first part of the defensive job, let's say the simulated defensive job, because they know exactly what we are looking for. If you put a player, he will try to be smart, he will try to cheat, he will try to get, if you put a coach, and you say, make this opposition, but we want to practice this situation, most of the time, I also found coaches which still have players' mentality, which I was putting them there to make this kind of simulated job. And they were cheating because they wanted to show to the player that they were forcing, where they were preparing the ball, they were stealing the ball. Say, hey, sometimes I had to stop them because they were next to five. Say, hey, wait, this is a practice. You are here just to help the player to improve. So, stay a little bit, a couple of steps behind you. Okay? Coach, you got to make a strong penetration dribble to the best, okay? With your inside. Coach, wait, wait, wait. Go ahead. Coach will jump on you, make opposition to this pass, make a quick pass right there with your right hand, start with your right, then do it with the left, and you, your job will be only catch and as fast as you can, bring it to the other side, make another side pass, right hand to the corner, take a shot. Okay? Okay? Easy. Then, rotation will be this. You will take the rebound and go there, you will after the pass, go to the corner, and after you shot, you will come. Okay? This way. We got it? Okay? So, go. Wait, wait, let me get it. Okay? Come on. Fast, fast, catch a shot. Go, go, come on. Go, go. Now we're traveling by rotation at the beginning. Okay, attack it, wait, attack the best. Attack the best. Go. I can't deflect it back. I am 49. Almost 50. Go. Come on. So, if you bounce the pass with no defense right there, what would you do when there would be more defensive way? He must receive the ball as fast as you can. So straight back now. You don't need the bounce pass. Go there. Do it again. Come on. Pass, pass, pass. Okay, catch the shooter. Okay. Okay, okay, so now, good, good, we okay? Okay, go back in line, go back in the line. We don't do it on the left side, but we do it in the breath. So we put, just wait, wait. Line on the left corner, and this is it. Now, just bring the ball here to the corner. Bring, just pass the ball to the corner, guys. Okay, okay, right here. Okay, now, we do the same starting from the corner. So you attack the basket, I will come to make your position. Quick pass, three-point shot. Okay? Okay? Go. 12, 12. Let's go. Come on. Go. Now, if they have to make a pass, catching the ball from the right, and passing right there, and they pretended to do it with the right, this is most easy. Let's say that they give to the defense more possibility to steal it or deflect. They have to catch the ball on the right, bring it to the left, as fast as they can. And make this pass maybe. Okay? Not catch a pass from here, because the defense, then we will put defensive player there. But now there are no defensive player, but start to teach them. Catch on the right, pass on the left. From the left, let's say. Okay? Go. Stop. If he doesn't have to make a jump over the field, come on, let's go. Fast, fast, right there. Okay, here's your shoot. Come on. Hold up. Okay, okay. One side, other side. Now, next step will be, you have different colors on your shirt, right? Okay, let's, anyway, let's make a group of three, green, and after a group of three, black. Okay? So, first group of three, green. Go back with the same first position with the ball here. Let's go. Ball is here. Ball is here. So, green, green, green. Still, one group in front. Green, green, green. Okay? Black, black, black. And then gray, gray, gray. Okay, ball is here. Wait, wait, wait. Spin. Right here. Right here. Gray in the corner. Black in the corner. Okay? Now, this is the final point where we get after we train a little bit. Now, this guy had to get beat, let's say, or send it to the middle. Attack one dribble, jump on it, make a rotation, defensive rotation, jump on it, run, start to run to the corner, make exactly what you were saying we were doing before, but now make a rotation, make a pass, make a pass, make a fast pass, shot. You don't have dribble. You can make a fake if it's coming with a jumping close up. You can make a fake, make a jump, and then shoot. Okay? So this is kind of point. This is the let's say the final competition they have when we want to train top level players. They still have 1 point for every deflection. They have 3 points when they make this pass. No, what do the player like? They take tough shots from the corner with the rotation jump. That's okay, but they start to learn that if the passes are fast and well executed, the corner shooter will have more time to catch and make his big three. We also put the coach calling seconds after one. So 5, 4, 3. So what we do not want, it is dribble, otherwise the first one. It's just to catch and pass for you. Right here, ball pass, don't fake, it's catch and pass and beat the rotation before the rotation time. Okay? You want to try it? Go. Still you have 3 points if you make it. You have 1 point if you deflect it. Deflect it doesn't mean put one small thing. Deflect it means make a change direction. Okay, make it good with a good hand. So, come on. So what? Of course, that point, you can make a shot. Or no, what happened? That the pass was bad right here because he had to do this to catch it. Okay? Try to do it better. Let's go. Take your shot, no dribble, okay? Now, offense, this change offense leave. Same job. Ready? Go. Here is the middle. Here, the passes were pretty good. Possibly the opposition was not that strong. They didn't go really aggressive in the back, in the flat. But the corner had a shot. So we have 3 groups of 3 and we go offense, defense, and outside. Okay, the next one. So we do it right to the left to the right, and also as we showed before, 3-0, corner to the backboard. Okay, not only backboard of the court. And this is something we work, let's say, first part is a kind of introduction to this we do at the beginning of the season. This is something we do basically every week. 5 or 6 minutes, also with the, let's say, our first team. We want to teach them to make extra passes under opposition in a competitive way. Well, let's go forward. We are talking about just speed rotation, of course. We skip a little bit of having to explain them why and when we do this. We do this when you beat your man, rotate on it. Good, but rotation comes. When rotation is coming, the right answer immediately is make a strong, quick pass in the same direction where rotation is coming. Okay, and not to flee, not to see, not to play. Rotation is coming. Beat the rotation with the best pass you can, opposite to the rotation direction. Okay, good. This is not against every ball. This is against full rotation, which is easy. Say that beat the rotation is a matter of skill, it's a matter of execution, it's a matter of will, because sometimes players see the rotation, but they say, hey, I won't fake, I won't make a shot. No, rotation is coming, make it effect. This is the right read-and-react situation we want. Okay, then you are very good, you can also beat the rotation quick. You don't care. We want to beat the rotation, making somebody else take an rotation. Okay, now, go one step forward, go back again with the 3 men with the ball here, the 3 men without the ball on the free throw line extension, 3 men without the ball on the free throw line extension, it's a group of 3. Okay? One with your 2 teammates who are your teammates in your group. Him and him. Okay? The other guy behind him, free throw line extension, we need a third guy there, possibly. Okay? And a third ball here. Okay? Now, again, I was talking about coach. Roll. Now what we want to do is train Decision maker who penetrate the dish situation. We want this guy attack the basket, going minimal extent to the blue line to make a layup. Okay? And the two wings follow his penetration, creating a better space, going to the point. Okay? Go, 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 go now. Coach is here. Okay? We have only one coach doing the job. We say at the beginning, always dish off on right side. Okay? What I will do will be here, make some opposition in the shot, make this pass, and then I will make a close up. Either hand up on the shot or two hands down right here. Okay? Okay? So after this pass, keep going, keep going. Make your penetration around the corner, wrist fade right there. Okay? If you can get in the middle, fine, still is enough. Now, we want him to test and make the right decision. If I go on your shot, now there's your man which is helping and recovering. No rotation is happening. I am your own man. I'm going against his penetration and recovering on you. So against this, what you will do is start your shooting move, but beat me with the second penetration to the basket. Kicking out for a three-point shot right there, outside the three-point line, one of them. If, I recover, hands down, yes, you should. Okay? We have two coaches. We will put the second coach on the weak side. He will be, he will do another close-up. Okay? Now, I am by myself, so let's do it. Okay? So only right. Okay? Now, think, Rotation will be this way again. In the river here, okay? Okay? Let's go. Hey, bravo! You love your step. Come on, let's go. Go. Hey, okay. That's good. Now, at least, again, I have 49, I cannot be. No, no, always right, always right. Okay? Okay? Shoot the ball. Okay? Come on. Second, wait. Two strong dribbles to make it double. And then you dish off when somebody else will really come. Do it again. Do it again. Let's go. Look. If you can dish off the ball off the dribble, not stopping, take it with two hands, put the ball inside the chest and outside the chest, you're wasting time. So, off the dribble, outside your body already, because the difference is coming. Okay? We got this? So, wait. The right, the left, changing position. Now we put the ball. Let's move to the corner. Move a little bit more like this. Right there, okay? You do the same, you attack the basket, okay? I am that defender, now we'll close up, okay? Make your strong penetration, the basket, go out in the corner, come, recover, and jump it on your shot, what are you gonna do? Of course, do it, come on, set, wait, this is not the penetration, this is true. Penetration is when you attack the basket. Attack the basket to make it up because I'm jumping you. You're 1-1. You gotta call somebody else to stop you. If they don't come, you go. Okay, we got it. So we start within a different spacing situation, basically safe. Okay? And define it again. Go, go. Okay. Out of the circle. Okay? Finally, let's put. Ball a little bit lower, but go to the opposite corner. Go to, no, opposite corner. Ready? Now we are in a clean out situation, but the principal spirit of the drill is the same. We attack the basket, in, we help from the weak side. Now, go, attack the basket. Minimum base of that way. You attack the basket, I am coming, dish out the ball, wherever. Right there. I'm playing like close out wherever it is to the ball. So the trick for our basketball. Well, each of the ball where there are already two forwards, even three if you don't have a good spacing, we come back on the same side. When we dish off the ball where there's only one player, we can go also the same side. It's there. Now you penetrate, dish the ball there, come back on your side ready. If you penetrate and kick, you must be ready to take the triple. Okay? Now clear out situation. Okay? Okay? Go. Okay, I didn't get it. Of course. I'm late. But if you see somebody jumping on you, you better work. It's a matter of training the decision making more than training. You should over people. Okay? So everything is clear so far. This is simple, but again, we are talking stuff, we are running with the professional. Now, still, we don't need a third group of training. We can have three guys who are 16 average tool. Can you come and decide this? What is the coach? Can you come decide this? Thank you. So you send me the big man when I will ask you, okay? Thank you. Now, let's start. Talk about mid rotation, talk about penetrating and kick. Now we'll talk about a little bit about strings. Okay? Now let's have a group with the ball here, but now we have a couple of players. Okay, come in. Let's put, well, simply the three big. Okay, fine. So let's have three group, the group of three, right here. Okay? Right in the top. Then we have one big man here screening. 14. Then we can make a big house. Okay? These two guys just outside ready to step in. Okay? Make a pass. Right there. And start to run right there. Wait. Now, we can go to coach. We have two coaches. We have only one go back to the side. We can start, for example, to make take for given that this guy is trained. And we want to put opposition on this fence. Okay? Just be straight. Your trick. Okay? So your defender is going right behind you. So your answer will be a curve. Right? Good. Perfect. Okay? This one. Okay? Start with this, not too much. Just start just to make correct progression. Now, it's working in the left. Now, we put the defense here. Okay, so you go making a curve, you take a shot from the elbow, but we want to start to give it to think. This defender is doing what most of the defenders are doing on this leg. So jumping on him. Okay? So you catch it, and put it on the floor. You should move away from him. Make side pass your team because his man is coming helping on this goal. Okay? So you attack the best and you see that this time wins the next best. Okay? You got it? Go ahead. Alright. Come on. Go. Back right there. Okay? Okay. Boom. Again. Come on. Go. Fast. Fresh. Now. Cool. No. This is it. Okay? Edge is there. Come now. At the beginning, maybe we should have begun the right, we can make a right pass, which is a little bit easier. But still again, coach here will stay a little bit more on his shoulder, a little more on this side, to make him train the pass we wanted to press. Okay? Now, go back. Make this pass. Just work against. Good. Very good. Come on. Go. Attack the back, okay? Now, next step. We still don't make change, you know, right to left. Okay. Now, this guy can be a chair also. Okay, now we put in just two. We have big men, so they start to do. Now, next pass. Go. Now, the defense is on the big, so it's a different time. hurt here, because we take for given that this man is straight now. Okay? Okay? Or if you want, don't put opposition there. Don't put opposition there. And we do this. But what we want it is he curves and he is ready to read big man. I am the big man defender. Okay? Reaction that on your narrow curve.
Now, go ahead with some micro situation.
Now, the two group of forwards, say, one is here with the ball, trick is here with the ball, right here with the ball. And the other one is here. Real line extension without. Three demon are on opposite side right here. First one ready to step in. Ready. Okay? Now to work a little bit on reading the defense on Figueroa's push. Make a pass. Go over here. Visualize one expression we use a lot. It is because we cannot do the defense when we make threes on every position. Visualize it. Give the player the game. Defense is doing this. But we ask them to see in their mind the defender player, the defensive player doing that. I mean, and players tell us that this is very helpful. In terms of really physically visualize somebody who's doing their job, of course, best situation when we put the coach, but still, we can put the coach in evidence. So, visualize the difference, which is on you. You want to go, receive a screen here, and go back in the same position, catching the ball from your teammate right there. Okay? And then, receiving a screen, bigger or screen way. Okay? What we want to treat here? We did it basically this. Show you which kind of a probable reaction defense will bring this move and taking the right decision to make them pay for this. Make the right, the most dangerous thing you can do according to the defense reaction. So the first move will be go behind. Okay? Now, if he goes behind, you have two options. One is shooting, and we want to train him first, okay? So I am the defense, I am the defense on the catch right here, screen is coming, the 3-point line, it will be higher. I go behind, and I want him to work on this situation. Meaning the hand, okay? Catch you up, on me, okay? Behind, go, turn. He's going behind, screen, turn. Okay? Go, step back and shoot. Okay? How many players do you allow to shoot? Every time, I like clear indication of the play. You cannot say, shoot, but then you shoot. I prefer to say, you and you have green light to take Navarro and Rudy Fernandez. Green light to take a three-point shot, also the first time. Even goes behind, take a three-point shot, and okay, if you want, do not want to take the shot, you want to take his money. But I authorize you to take it. Okay? Other players, now make games. But they are great players. Okay? We tell them, don't shoot at the first. Okay? But go behind. Change your angle perfect. Get closer to the basket. Change your hand right here. And then, the second time, goes behind, riding, right back step, again, keep swinging, and shoot. Second time, I want everybody to shoot. I hate to see my players beat, repeat, repeat, four beat, repeat, and then we get to 5 seconds. But I prefer to give them the confidence and to make them ready to shoot and to prepare the team to go to perfection or whatever. But, second time on the repeat, there is a shot. The defense go under and under, it is a shot. So all we're going to do now, it is exactly this. I will go under and under, attack it, back, prepare with the screen, take a shot. Okay? Let's go. Then, we change. Okay? Go there, repair with the change, and you stay always the same. Got it? Okay? Come on, go. Right here. Oh. Somebody has a screen, and you go right here, you catch the ball, and Asia. Okay? Now I'm here, you can't take a shot. Piccolo is coming. Okay? Go behind, I go behind. Repeat. Second time, again behind. Stay there. Perfect. Shot. We do it. We do it. Hey, come. We want the shot, isn't it? We want the shot, isn't it? Come on. Let's go. See the screen, follow the screen, I'm here, behind, behind, back, shot. Okay, okay, perfect. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Stay, stay, stay.
Come up.
Okay, for defense, it's going visualize your defender, it's going behind. Okay? Now, go. Repeat. Second one. Now, big men can do two things, basically. There are many small in there, but one would be take care of this man. Second one, they stay loose, don't go out on the shot. Okay? Then the game will be many situations, so keep on the sidewalk for later. Now, if he's taking care of this, what we want is this, that you keep going. You roll into the basket, keep going. The very important thing is this, we do not want, unless he's really quick on passing in the traffic, a pass from here straight. We want to make a fast dribble and force the demon to define better and to create a better spacing with him. Okay? So attack him. Bring the demon to you. He wants to come with you. Bring it with you. Make a bounce pass right there. And your job is in the same. Catch it. Dribble full. Power shot. Okay? Let's do it. Go. Okay, fine. Okay. Under. Two, one. Okay. Want to create a better spacing than that. Of course, there are great questions. Three shorts. No, you don't tell him to go wider, to find better spacing situation. Join him with three fingers, you catch the ball and pass it right, you know, to the roll and hit it. This is really, really tough spacing situation. You better create the better spacing. Since we see that the big really want to take care of the ball on the big, we want to create a better space and a better space to the ball. Second option, okay? Go. Now, let's go with other three guys. Go. Okay. Wow, come in. Go. Who is it? Right here. Take your screen. Fine. Right here. Defense screen. Defense is going behind. Repeat. Now. Wait, defense is going over, but let's add, as we were saying, what the big man is doing. Okay? Now, big man is not coming at your shot. Big man stays inside. Okay? Right here. Okay? So go. Think of the defense. Okay? Make me follow this. Make me change direction when you see my feet inside. Okay? Really lower. Attack the open side. Oh, okay, fine. Go. Now, going over, but defense is here. Oh, we have the shot. But what we are most of the time wanting to do in this situation is this on the rim. Right here. Okay? Is this. I'm threading you. Okay? Big man, wait there. Big man is here. We want to separate from the defense. We want to create an extra problem to the big man. Again, instead of going to the side, try to go to the middle again. So, you got me? Go here. Again, change your hand and tap that up. And roll on this side. Okay? Why? We want to create an extra problem to the big. This is something which we are working on. Normally no, because the big man will stay loose. But let the big lateral move this ball. Go. Okay, big. No. Go. The wall move. Okay, bigger it. You can't pick bigger it. Okay? I don't want to go up. Okay, wait. He's moving like this. Let the big lateral move this way. Attack the other side. He got a turn. This is a really trouble situation for him. Because they take one other move, another other move, and then be in trouble to the side, either go to the shot, or in this case, if he doesn't come and take a shot, or if he comes to the shot, let alone the roll. Okay? So go back again. Go back again. Now, I will go. I will be the small man defender. Wait. Okay? So, go. Turn your angle. Okay, change your angle, ladies, because I'm trying to train him. He wants want to sleep, you want to go over there. Okay? So for me it's much more difficult if you scream like this. Go. Okay? Go with your feet. Okay? You will see it in an even clearer way of the side of situation against a force to the base and the defense. Which is, I think, the best option we have. Okay? One other thing we do now, when the defense is inside, is to practice another kind of a pass, which is, let's say now, don't make your goal. You just pass the ball, replace yourself, go, come back, okay, right here now. Attack the basket, attack the back from this side, defense is going behind, but defense, pigment is pretty much it. You go, roll it, you mean. Okay? Come on. Try to have him out of the three-point line. Try to keep the pigment worried about. Try the best, but also bring it. Okay? So now what we want to do is this. Prepare the pigment. Roll again. We'll give now the defender here. Make a quick pass right there. Now, you're coming in this case, you're coming like this, legs. Okay? Pass pair right here, turn and pivot, pass the pigment rolling right here. Okay? So we go and we, pigment is loose again. The defender of the pigment doesn't want to step up. So we have an option to attack him on the junction, on the split. But one very good option also it is to use this space. Okay? For the pigment to roll over him and not passing straight from the passing, because he will find the defense right behind himself, right between even the passing. But with a defense like this, pivot for this way to receive the pass from the other side and to turn straight to the passing. Without the lead, there's a 20 degree which make a difference possible in the defender position. So go back again and let's do it. That will be defending the pigment. Okay?
There, in the middle figure of where it is useful but not necessary.
my feeling is this side kicker against defense who forced the big man with the big man defending loose right here. This case, since defensively speaking, I want to keep the ball to the corner. It is clear that offensively speaking, I want to play the ball to the okay? What do we want to do? First of all, we put the defense coach here, and we make a force of the base and defense, but not a good one. What do you mean? Not with my higher foot over his feet. Mean, of course, lower that. Mean that I can attack the middle. This is something which sometimes we don't even see. We see that the defensive push to the base. What we have to do now, defensive push to the base. First thing, check if they are playing the defense. Check if they are really make it impossible because their footwork is correct, the foot position more than footwork is correct, to not to let them go to the middle. Because if the rhythm, front rhythm is this, his higher foot, if he's low, sprinting to the middle, shoulder to shoulder, don't let me take his space.
Good.
Attack to the middle. This will kill any kind of force to the paint. Because defender on the ball will be out, and will be one. Okay? So the first move will be, don't distract the force to the paint in difference. Attack it to the middle, and we put the court right here in order to make them visualize the fact that my feet are not in the correct position. Okay? Take it for you. Now, next step. Pass the ball there, go to screen. Now, defense is in the correct position. Okay? What do we want to do? Let alone how to defend. We take for given this is okay. Let's see how high is the big. This is the decision maker. If the big man is really high, what we want is attack him, roll, bounce the pass right there. Okay? First case, we put the coach. It's two or three. It's two or three. Start from, okay? Go. Come on. No. Okay. Your defender is fine. Okay? So we go. Your defender is fine. Meaning the pigman will change his angle. Okay? It's really good. Okay? Now, case one, it is you try, you see that the defender is correct, now you change your angle, okay? Defense is pretty high. Pretty high. Okay? So what we're gonna do is try to make him come a little bit more on you, bound the ball right there. We want to see if one dribble we can do it. But as we said before, maybe if it's pretty high, you want to be careful, maybe second dribble can find to make him get the position where he doesn't have to. You know what I mean? So keep him, make him two dribble, let him get to the basket where he can catch and finish without him. Okay? That's good. Go. Ready? Okay. Both the legs. Ready? Ready? Okay. Go. Bounce. But there will be somebody else in the we send them on. You will have pressure. Okay? Case two, which is even more free. Put the ball there. Difference is correct pushing to the base. So we change your end. Fine. Well, the defender defense is pretty low. Okay, it's dangerous. What we want to do every time in this game, split. Attack the free throw. Wait. Not there, you cannot go because you have a defender. What can you do? Good. Keep your split. In all cases of split, we ask the big man to hold the screen a little bit more. Okay? Like this. So you may hold it a little bit. Attack the free throw. Right there. And again, we have the same situation we would like to have on the side kick around. Attack in the middle with the big man rolling on the side with all the way side in front of us and not getting caught in a corner. And with the euro, even more. We don't want to be, we cannot be too aggressive attacking, getting forced to the corner, attacking the corner. We do want to go to the middle. want to get the free throw, change the angle, squeeze it right here with a quick change of hand, right below your knees, right here, and go to the free throw line. Take a shot or you hit the rope. Okay? We do it, let's go, do it one time. And then we change it, guys. Let's go. Come on. Thank you. Stay with the shot. Okay? Go. Come on. Go. Okay. Ready? Come on. Any shot. Okay, we go on that. Okay, good. Go straight. Go straight. Go to the base. Okay, okay. Now I get to react. If I go in a shot after that, you will make a pass to the road. If I still stay loose, you will take a shot. Okay? Use the screen on side of your difference. End of force is final. This is something which is give 1 split second to the defense to react. Let's go to the high post. They will prepare to hand off. It's also okay with option to attack the lead, not to get forced to the corner. But use the split, it is faster to keep the defense under pressure. You don't give it that second for the defense to readjust when you first to the high post to go for it. Okay? Okay? Hold that. You could get again in 1 hour and 20 minutes. We had to give an idea of what we do during possibly 1 evening. The idea is again show to our guys what they will find defensively, what kind of reaction they will possibly find on the court when they will try to play 1-1, with the rotation, use a screen, use a side or a little girl, and train them to make the right reaction. It's not a matter of inventing something, or being a genius who, right there without having tried nothing in practice, can define the solution. For solution, this is a solution. 3-4 solutions. Then again, the skill, the talent of the player will give them option to do something more. Something, let's say, more personal interpretation of how to do it. But the way to do it, the way to work is that kind of defensive reaction is there. And the more we will practice, the more we will train them to see and react, the most probable will be in the game that they will make the right decision. It doesn't mean make a basket every time. Making the right decision gives you more probability to finish the basket. But not again, the personal skills of the player will be important or not. Okay? So we're going to take a break, right? And if you have any questions about this first part of our meeting, we can do it after the second part, because the second one will be finished. It's a shorter, we'll have some time again for